30 matches over, 30 men eliminated, one match to go, just two men left. Will it be Ted Hankey? It will be Ronnie Baxter, who is this year's Embassy World Professional Darts Champion and whose name will join those famous roll of honour that includes Bristow and Lowe, Taylor and Wilson. They're playing tonight not just for the title of world champion, but also £44,000 first prize money. We're here in the practice arena just behind the main stage. As you can see, the two guys are throwing their last sets of darts in earnest. If we could just interrupt Ted May as he finds 19. How are you approaching this, your first final?
I'm all right. It's basically the same as any other game. It's like I was saying to the day, you've got to play your game on the day, as you do, so quite happy.
Yesterday you played some extraordinary darts. You actually landed more 180s than outs, than doubles, which is almost unprecedented. Are you, in a funny kind of way, are you almost worried that you played that well yesterday?
Well, to be honest with you, I didn't think I played that well yesterday because I missed a lot of doubles. When you're up there, you don't realise what you're doing. You know, you go up there just to play darts. You know, when Martin said there was 22 on 80s, I thought, well, that's nice. You know, but they say you go up there to win. Your main objective is to win. And that's basically the same main objective today, is to win.
Well, you certainly got through in a titanic duel yesterday. Ronnie, if I could bring you in, you had a rather more straightforward semi-final yesterday, and you've been here before because you obviously were in the final last year. Does that mean that the nerves are at bay, whereas perhaps they might have been raging 12 months ago?
They won't be at bay for the first leg, maybe. But once we settle in, then it should be okay after that. We'll relax a bit more, and then we should have a good game.
Last year, 6-5, and it really could have gone either way. What lessons have you learned from that final last year?
Not to miss double top. Simple as that.
Because it's all about finishes, isn't it? Isn't it? You can score as many 180s as the cows come home, but if you don't actually finish things off, it doesn't get you anywhere.
It doesn't get you nothing. If you can't finish, you don't win.
What's the playing record between you two?
Oh, I don't know. What would you say? 50-50?
Right, we played each other a lot of times. A lot of times.
Yeah.
But like I said yesterday, I said we'd see more fireworks than December 31st, 1999. Tonight, you'll see more fireworks than yesterday.
Well, let's hope you're right, because we certainly had two fantastic semi-finals. Totally impartial here. Best of luck to the both of you.
Thanks.
Just throw a few more to get into the rhythm. And they will very shortly be called away from this practice arena. As you know, Ted is called the Count, so he'll be here prepared in his cape with a few bats to throw at the crowd. And a Ronnie, who's known as the Rocket, will doubtless be thinking about throwing a few extra sets into that board, from his point of view, preferably into the triple 20. And as you stand here, it's like being in a dental waiting room. You're just waiting for the call.
Please welcome on stage our studio host, the BBC's John Inverdale.
Thank you very much. Been a fantastic audience, obviously, for the entire week, but I'm sure you can manage one even greater rousing welcome for our next guest.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legend, a gentleman has done an absolute fabulous job in promoting our sport for BBC this week. Ladies and gentlemen, be upstanding, the King, Bobby Jones!
So, Bobby, you've been here and done it a couple of times. Sadly, though, you lost on both occasions. But what's it like in the...
Thank you, John. And
you're obviously delighted that I reminded you of that. But what's it like when you're waiting outside knowing you're about to get called out for a world final?
It's a little bit nervous. That's the nervous part of the game, waiting to be called out. But once they come through that door, and all you ladies and gentlemen out there, give them a nice cheer. It makes them all tingle. And it's a feeling that you cannot get. You can't buy that. You people give it to these players when they come out. And that's why I do it every year, because I love that feeling. That's why I come back all the time.
But just tell us about the tactics of this game, because it's the best of 11 sets, so it's longer even than the semi-finals were yesterday. So is it one of those matches where even if you start badly, you can still feel in your inside that you've got time to make it up?
Yeah, you can lose two sets in this and still come back, but no player wants to do that. In the final, you want to beat them 6-0 if you can. And that's what they'll be trying to do against each other.
That's what John Part did in...
What a nice man, isn't he?
So, and just tell us, Ronnie's been here before in a final. Is that an advantage for him?
Yeah, I think it is. Ronnie knows the rules now. I don't think he let it slip this time. He's a very robotic player. He's a 30 dart man all the time. He doesn't look like he's enjoying himself, even when he's winning. So he's a hard guy to beat. But if Ted hits his 1080s and he hits his doubles, then who knows?
And a final thought for you in front of the audience here. Is it possible, do you think, for a 55-year-old to win this championship next year?
Well, what I say, I'll ask the audience, do you think I can win it next year? Well, John, does that answer your question?
I think the jury's still out. Bobby, thank you very much. So that's what Bob reckons, anyway, about what might happen this evening. Here are the views of some of the other leading protagonists in this year's event.
For a time yesterday, it looked as though you might have beaten Ronnie Baxter. What advice can you offer Ted Hankey now as he goes out to play him this evening?
I don't have to give him any advice so far as it seems to me now at the moment, but I have to say Ronnie has to improve his scoring. There's nothing wrong with his doubles, they're going brilliant, and Ted is a big fighter. If Ronnie goes ahead on him and Ted is behind, he's bound to come back today, he has to, and he's probably going to do that.
Well, when I spoke to Ted yesterday after his match, he was quite confident that he was going to beat Ronnie Baxter, and the way Ted's playing yesterday was brilliant, and I think it's going to be a great match either way, whoever wins. So I just want to see a great match. I would like to see it go to 5-all, five sets all, and a tiebreak, and that's what the people want to see.
Just tell us, what is it like for the players when they wander out there?
If it's your first time, it's absolutely awesome. When you've been here one or two times, you start to really enjoy that special atmosphere that Lakeside gives us.
We've seen some great matches at the Lakeside. Do you think the final could be a great one?
Yeah, I think it'd be a really good final. And if Ted hits his doubles, I think Ted will win it. But if Ted doesn't hit his doubles, Ronnie will make him pay. Because it's all going to come down to the finishing.
How much will nerves play a part?
It's not so much nerves, it's more the adrenaline. They're both very experienced players, they've both won major titles, so I don't think that'll affect them too much.
Why do you say Ronnie Baxter?
I don't know, Ronnie's just one of them players, you know what I mean? You can play in a local pub on a big stage, he just goes up and does it.
What's going to be the key to tonight's match?
Consistency, I think, and finishing. You must hit those doubles at the end.
Who's your money on?
That's a toughie. I think I might go with Ronnie. I think so.
So, opinion divided. In fact, the first dart in this championship was thrown what seems a very, very long time ago at 1 o'clock Saturday week. This is how the two finalists got to this stage.
That's a record tire.
Oh, it's
set the championship record.
Well, it's time for the talking to stop. It's time for the final of this year's Embassy World Professional Darts Championship.
Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, let's play darts! Please welcome the number 5 seed, England's Ted Hankey! Please welcome the number 2 seed, Ronnie Baxter!
Well, there we have it. You can see the atmosphere. Big build-up, and I'm sure that these two players will oblige with the standards that they've shown us through the week. We'll be taking the practice darts, and there is the trophy of the world. So many, many great players on that trophy. 23 years ago, it was Leighton Rees. 5 times Eric Bristow, but tonight a new champion. Will it be Ted Hankey? Or will it be the Rocket, Ronnie Baxter? Well, we're going to find out. These are just the practice darts. All I can say is get the best seat in the house. Get the flask of tea by the side, because I think you're in for some excitement. Another 3 darts to go. It's the best of 11 sets is the final. The stage is set for a grand final at that. And John, I'm sure you'll have 1 or 2 words.
Yes, and I'm certainly expecting a lot of high scores and some high finishing.
Game on, play.
First out of the final. It's Hankey.
45.
Just one more maximum. We're taking past the record of the championship, which was 39 by Raymond Barneveld. Switching.
177.
Well, he seems the favourite as far as the players are concerned, and as the bookies go, he's 15-8 on his Baxter. He could have 11-8.
140.
Yes, and Ronnie already looking to take advantage in this first leg of the match.
140.
He's only missed 1 dart, so 4 out of 6. The other 5 in the treble beds.
The winner's check, £44,000.
100.
In actual fact, John, there's £22,000 on the match, if you look at it that way.
Yes, and there's no other match in this tournament
94.
That compares to this final. I mean, the final, it's twice as difficult to face as the semifinal. Just a whole other experience.
140.
Down to the nitty-gritties.
Ronnie require 90.
For the first leg, options here could go for the bull or treble 18. It's gone for 60. So double 15. Well, 7 leaves double
82.
4.
82. Ted require 76.
Treble 20. Well, 73. Can treble 19 double 8? Well, 14 for double top.
36. Ronnie require 8.
Very fast players. It's on with the job at double 4. Double 2. Now double 1.
6. Ted, you require 40.
Double top, his favourite double. It's double 10. And it's double 5.
35.
Not jingling.
This is what happens. It's the effect. It's just the whole other thing entering the final stage. The nerves are tingling. It's a good marker.
No score. Change your require 5.
Single 1, double 2. Double 2. Double 1.
No score.
I've never seen this as a start of a championship jump.
And it's still, we have to remember, it's just a break opportunity.
No score. Ted, you require 5.
1, double 2. Double 2. That's the marker he's looking for.
3.
But obviously the expression tells you that dart wasn't in.
2.
Okay, Annie's room. Or Madhouse. It's double ones apiece.
No score.
Well, in the semi-finals, we'd have got through the first set by now. Double one.
No score. Ronnie, you require 2.
Well, never have we seen it before. It's got the crowd going. That's Rachel, is Ronnie's girl. Rachel Pallister.
No score. Take your require 2.
Well, when there was practicing outside, there was practicing on the trebles. I think the doubles is the one we should have practiced on. Double one, though.
Yes! Game shot! At first leg!
Well, the smile's all right. I should say, what a great leg to win.
Well, Tony, I've seen players win sets in that many darts.
Run first. Game on.
29 darts. That's what it was. But still.
43.
I think we'll settle down in a minute.
Well, it certainly does help to settle you down. You just get that one bad leg, the one gets all the nerves out of you. Then.
60.
Especially the newcomers. I mean, they need a set, don't they? Custom to the throw.
140.
The other thing, John, is that when they're practicing, they're outside, they're on a different board. They're there for about an hour and a half, 2 hours.
123.
Well, I think perhaps the pre-match hype, you know, players could hear all the interviews and everything else being said, and
100.
I think perhaps just built the adrenaline level a little too high when they came out on the stage. It's awfully hard to shut out everything you hear going on just prior to when you go
121.
But Baxter, with the advantage of this leg. It's on the throw.
45.
Slipping. And Hanke's chance. Switching for 19s.
97.
No out shot, 173.
One 100. Take your require, 100.
Treble 20, double top. Still treble 20 for double 10. It's double 10 for 2-0, first set.
Yes, game shot, single leg, Ted Hanke.
2-0 it is then, to the Hanks.
Third leg, Ted to throw first, game on.
Well, that leg was in almost half the darts of the first leg, so definitely settling in a 15-dart leg.
100.
And Ronnie having beat Scott Wollaston, the American, Bobby George, Colin Monk, Coe Stompe.
140.
Way to the final. Ted, Bob Taylor, Steve Douglas, Kevin Painter, Chris Mason. Well, the cheers ring out. That is the record now. 40 180s in the tournament.
28.
And he's looking really good for this first set.
$100.
And that record was held by still world champion until this match. The final is go, Ray Barneveld.
100.
Handing over his crown. Treble 20. Go for 11 and ball. Well, he's gone for 25, double 18.
93.
In fact, if Ted was to repeat his performance in the semi-final, he'd end up with 61, 180s. So we never know what kind of record 15. Might end up being set here.
Ted, you require 28.
Double 40.
Yes, game shot. And the first set. Ted Hankey.
That's the first set to Hankey.
Second set, first leg, Ronnie to throw first. Game on, please.
So the players now have settled down. We're moving on now. First leg.
140.
Second set. Now Ted stands right across the hockey.
134.
And he's carrying on now where he left off against Chris Mason. Best Embassy semi-final we've ever seen.
140.
There it is. And there are some names on there. Leighton Rees was the first champion, going back 23 years. In actual fact, it was legs then.
100.
Best of 21 legs. Now it's set, and in actual fact, if it went all the way, it would be 61 legs. Big difference.
100.
And John Part's name is on that trophy as well, John.
Yes, and it's something you never forget.
60. Ronnie require 121.
Counting his chances, but here's an out shot. Treble 17, maybe. Well, just playing it safe.
39.
And the safe way doesn't always pay, Tony.
Well, not really, because 82, he still could be using up three darts. 167.
60. Ronnie require 82.
Rachel sits there patiently. Could be bull double 16. Single 17. Double top. Bent
42.
The wire.
Ted, you require 147.
Treble 20. No, so it'll be double top for Ronnie Baxter after these three.
87.
Yes, and he's still looking for his first double of the match. 40. So still a little nervy, perhaps. Double top. Double 10.
30.
Well, he's missing the doubles that he was
Ted
hitting.
Ted, require 60.
20. It's his favourite, double top.
Yes, game short. And the first leg. Ted Hankey.
Four legs on the trots.
Second leg, Ted to throw first. Game on.
Well, Ronnie is hitting doubles. He was hitting high finishes. Everything in his semi-final match.
140.
It was clinical.
Well, this is showing just how important it was, whoever hit that double one in the very first leg of the match.
90.
Ted hit it, and now he's settled in. To Ronnie, yet to find a double in the match.
140.
One big thing going for Ronnie is the fact that he has been in a final. Last year he lost 6-5 to Raymond Barneveld.
59.
There's the hand that could hold the crown.
80.
Had one or two bounce outs throughout the week. Not very happy for the players.
30. Ted, you require 141.
Well, treble 20 would have helped. 121 left. 118.
43.
There's Mike Gregory. Well, we saw the greatest final ever here against Phil Taylor and Mike.
22.
And that one did go 61
Taylor
legs.
98.
Treble 20. Well, he may not go for double 19. His options. We'll see. He's gone for it.
60.
And the reason he went for it. 292 points still required for Ronnie Baxter.
81. Ted, you require 38.
Still double 19, but he may have gone for 14 and double 12. This is the double he was missing.
Yes, game short. And a single leg.
Double 12s, double tops.
Third leg, Ronnie to throw first, game on.
It's a bit unusual, a player that prefers double 12 to double 16. But,
99.
He likes to stay on either the double top or that double 12.
But in honesty, it nearly lost him the semi-final against Chrissy Mason at double 12.
140.
It's been a full house from day one. They've had some enjoyment.
100.
If you're wondering what that is, that's the score pad. That's what the players go by.
90.
Well, the title will be coming back to England for the first time since 1996.
100.
Well, there they are. There's the lads. Chelsea pension, ever present.
140.
Yes. There's a few years amongst those gentlemen. And a few medals as well.
140. Wow.
Good shot from Ronnie there. Pressures this out shot. Needs a treble 20. Treble 17. Or treble 13. There's 59 left, so 19 would leave double top, Tony. And there it is.
91. Ronnie requires 62.
For his first leg, treble 10, double 16. Single 12, he likes double top. He's gone for double 16 for a change.
30.
Well, he wasn't hitting double top.
Ted, you require 40.
But he's hitting double top, is Ted. Double 10.
Yes, game short. And a second set. Ted Hankey.
Well, we saw that first leg.
First set, first leg. Ted to throw first. Game on, please.
Took about 5 or 6 minutes, but as soon as he hit that, Ted is already two sets up and cruising.
83.
Well, John, this is a turnaround for us, isn't it?
Well, it's just a matter of when Ronnie starts playing, but he doesn't want to leave it too late.
177.
He's had two 177s. I think it's worth mentioning, John, you can finish still on a 9-dart finish from that score.
100.
Well, certainly can, and as Robbie Widow's enjoying it. I think we've all been surprised at Ronnie's slow start, however.
140.
Ted certainly in the form, though, that he showed in the semifinal.
41.
Definite chance to win a leg now. Little breathing space.
And against the throw as well. Only his seventh through ninth darts there.
So will we see a 180 knot after that first half?
And no finish at all, so all the pressure off of Ronnie, but he hasn't has yet to hit a double.
Treble 20 leaves double 12. Double 12. Good marker.
Yes, game short.
That will be a relief.
Well, his fans hasn't had much to cheer about, but they're there now, giving him everything.
Single leg, Ronnie to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, 12 dart leg. And that's what we were seeing all day yesterday from Ronnie Baxter.
60.
16. This is what we were seeing from
Ted.
Steve Nicholas, the referee.
100.
So a maximum with the first throw.
64.
Recovered well. 9 is the lowest score of the championship.
85.
Well, Ted's in good shape to break right back here in the set. Would be disappointing for Ronnie.
140.
Well, he's down on the finish of 117.
121. Ted, you require 117.
So Treble 20, treble 19 leaves double top. Double top for a 117 out shot.
77.
Oh, we saw the top wire bend.
Ronnie require 135.
Could take the ball of 25. Well, is it the three? So 132 left.
Nine.
Well, there it is.
Dead, you require 40.
Double top. Double 10.
Yes,
right in the corner.
Shot. And a second leg. Ted Hankey.
Breaks back.
Third leg, Ted to throw first. Game on.
Well, that was strange, yeah. John, we've had 2-9-9 scored in the championship, and then Ronnie, just after I'd mentioned it, goes and gets a 9.
60.
Well, a dubious achievement. But it was Ted with the 14 dart leg that took the advantage right back in this set. So a bit of trouble for Ronnie. There's the stance. Ted Hankey, heel to the Aki.
60.
He's right at the very right edge of that Aki as well. Shoots across the two towards the left.
There's Ronnie. He's much toe first. Central.
180.
Well, they're loving that. Them high out shots, them maximums, and they've had everything.
140.
Yes, we're seeing a lot of fight out of Ronnie now because he's looking to get yet another break. He really, I don't think he can afford to lose this set.
140.
He's certainly not taking any chances because he's on a two dart out shot.
134.
The pressure is on.
Ronnie require 82.
Ball leaves double 16. 17 leaves double top. It's double top.
62.
Another chance here for Hankey.
Ted require 107.
Treble 20. Well, is it 15? Can still finish. Treble 20 leaves double 16. Double 16.
Here's game shot. And a third leg.
That will have shook Ronnie Ted Baxter Hankey to the roots.
Fourth leg, Ronnie to throw first. Game on.
Well, his name is Rocket, but he hasn't taken off yet.
100.
Still trouble for Ronnie. If he holds his throw here, Ted will have the advantage in the deciding leg of the set.
100.
Well, there's Steve Duke, Martin and Sharon Adams, all the players in attendance.
140.
Many other stars with us today, John.
60.
Roger Black, one of the greatest athletes of Great Britain.
59.
From the snooker world, we've got John Higgins, Stephen Hendry, 7 times world MSA champion.
96.
A couple more up, and there is Stephen.
100. Ronnie require 145.
Treble 20, treble 15, double top. Treble 15. So treble 18, he'll go.
93.
And I expect Ted to pressure his shot.
100. Ronnie require 52.
12 leaves double top. Double top. Double 10 is rushing them.
32. Ted, you require 80.
For another set. Treble 20. Single 20 now. Double top. Oh,
60.
Just under. Ronnie to save
Ronnie
it.
Require 20.
Double 10.
Yes, game short. Fourth leg, Ronnie Baxter.
But as John said, he's still in trouble.
Row first. Game on.
It's Ted with a throw. Already away. And this is looking good. It's there. It's another. The bats are flying.
135.
4.
105
treble 20s and a leg that will give him the set. Forcing Ronnie into errors. Yes. 101 left.
100.
Well, he's left 81, and this is the finish that he was missing consistently against Chris Mason in the semi-final.
Well,
great shot from Ronnie to get himself to at least do a chance if Ted misses. 81.
Treble 19. Well, that's 9. So 72. Well, 12 for leaving double top. If
41,
he should get a throw.
Ronnie require 145
for the set. Treble 20. Yes. Treble 15. Unlucky.
79. Ted require 40.
Nothing for Rachel to cheer about. It's double top.
Yes,
even less now.
And the third set.
Donna Hankey applauding her husband. It's 3 Four sets to nil up.
Ronnie to throw first. Game on.
And off we go. First leg.
140.
Fourth set.
100. And we see some checkout stats. Ted Hankey throwing 26, hit 9, 34.61%. Pretty much average, but Ronnie Baxter, they're throwing 23, only hit the 2.
96.69%.
About 29 of those was thrown in the first leg of the match. Huey also.
180.
Well, applause there from Rachel. Another maximum for the count.
59.
There we are. It's been a relentless job there for the new Mercator. That gives all the areas of a large dartboard.
60
for the audience, and there's our ladies that scored all week, Mary Hawkins, Lorna Croft.
98. Ted, you require 161.
Treble 20, yes. Treble 17, he'll be going for it. 84 left, treble 20.
97. Ronnie, you require 108.
Well, he could go for 19s here. Another, a treble 19. Yes, double 16.
76.
Just click the wire.
Ted, you require 64.
Donna looking on. Maybe 8 double top. He doesn't like double 16.
Yes, that's the first leg. Ted Hankey.
That's the Hankey family.
Second leg, Ted to throw first. Game on.
3 sets to love. First leg, fourth set. And here we go again.
180.
Well, you could have put another 3 darts in there, all in the right-hand corner. Already a handful. 5 is had.
140.
So that's 44 for the championship. 180s.
100.
140 behind on this leg.
100.
Need to leave a handy finish. And he will be on a finish.
100.
So only pressure with this shot from Ronnie. But he's under pressure. And those darts are spelling it out.
30. Change required, 121.
Treble 20, yes, 61 left. He's got time on his hand. He's hit the ball instead of 25, so single throw.
113.
Leaves him 8. No outshot here for Ronnie.
He must find a treble.
59.
Still no outshot.
Ted, you require 8.
And that's his mum, looking at double 4.
Yes, go short. And a single leg. Ted Hankey.
Paul Williams looking on a bit.
Everyone. Ronnie to throw first. Game on.
Well, the player's favourite, the bookie's favourite, was Ronnie.
100.
And there's the match stats. Ted Hanke, 17 100s, 11 140s, 5 180s, 91.98 three dart average. Make that 6 180s. And Ronnie Baxter, 14 100s, 13 140s, 1 180, and only an 84.44 three dart average. And that's well below his so far in the championship what he's done. He's always been in the 90s before this.
Yeah, 90.70, first 90.85.
140!
But Stephen Hendry, a lot faster game than what he plays.
100!
Well, yes, they're out, even though it's daylight. Down to 81. The hairstyles have never changed, John.
95. Ted, you require 81.
Treble 19. Losing 62. He's going for the ball. And it's there. He can't miss a thing.
And the fourth set. Ted Hanke.
Four sets to love. The Hanke family out there. Everything to cheer.
Fifth set, first leg. Ted to throw first. Game on, please.
There's nothing Ronnie can do.
96.
With a long way to go, but will it be Ted Hanke? As we are going at the moment, it's looking very much that way.
Yes, and that was a 12 dart leg, finishing with the ball to take the fourth set. In fact, Ronnie's only won two legs in the match. He's been completely out of it.
100.
There's Mervyn and Vicky, his girlfriend Mervyn King, but this man could be king today.
140.
Already in command of this leg.
100.
Not an out shot. 15 and leave him double top.
95.
Kept his waiting. It's 70 left.
138. Ted requires 70.
Well, if he wants double top, it's treble 10. He now wants single 20. Oh, he's bust.
No score.
And these are the kind of things that can turn around the match.
Ronnie requires.
What an opportunity. Treble 20. Single 20 for double top, and look at this, it just
40.
He knew how important that shot was.
Ted, you require 70.
Once again, treble 10. He's at 45, so 25 left. Double 12, that's his double he goes for, and he's got it tonight.
Game shot, first leg. Ted Hanke.
It's a parade of legs and sets for Ted Hanke.
Right first, game on.
Such a build-up.
40.
Everyone expecting Ted Hanke to do well and Ronnie Baxter to take it. But look at this, Hanke. 112, 313s, 214s, 315s. Only 112 dart finish for Ronnie Baxter.
140.
Well, Ronnie's got to wake up. Well, that's the hand and the grip. Ted Hanke.
96.
You'd have to think pretty much impossible to return from a 5-0 set deficit. So you'd have to say a must-win set for Ronnie Baxter.
60.
We saw the speed there of the Baxter. Well, John, you went in, didn't you? At 5-0. And look at this. Ronnie Baxter on a finish of 161.
161.
Still 101 left. So favourite for another leg. Treble 20. Could go for treble 14. No, he went for another treble 20. So 80, 62 left. Options here. Treble 10 would leave double 16.
90. Ronnie Ruquois, 101.
Vital one, John. Take it away.
Yes. He's gone for 19. 82 left. Bull or treble 14. He hasn't done it, so he's left double
61.
Top.
61.
But shouldn't get a chance.
Ronnie Ruquois, 52.
2-0 fifth. Double top.
Yes, game short. And the second leg, Ted Hackey.
Four sets up, 2-0 up, fifth set.
Third leg, Ted to throw first. Game on.
Off we go again. And it's Hankey. Oh, no. Yes, it is.
180.
Well, Rachel, look at her. Dejected, but a man still goes on. Having faced
100
maximum in this match. That's five, come on, let's have another. Unlucky.
140.
Thinking of the nine dart finish, £52,000 at stake. Playing like a bat out of hell, John.
100.
Yes, and certainly Ronnie looks like a man has already given up on it.
It's Donna Hankey.
100. Ted Uriqua, 81.
Trouble 19. Well, he left 62. He may not go for treble 10. Yes, he has his tried. So single 12.
41.
He knows he'll be coming back for double top. Needs them all.
100. Ted Uriqua, 40.
Double top for 5-0. Double 10.
20.
Well, if Ronnie can just get
Ronnie
into this.
Uriqua, 101.
Save the set. Well, he's gone down below. He's gone for 57. Double top.
81.
He's fast, he's furious.
Ted Uriqua, 20.
But this is the one. Double 10.
Yes, game short, and the fifth set, Ted Hankey.
Well, we've had about 40 minutes of play, five sets to love, as Ted Hankey leaves the stage. We're just taking a break. Well, I think, John, if the break's going to suit anyone, it has to suit Ronnie Baxter. But there it is, 5-0. And as we're looking here, John Hankey, five sets, 3-0, 3-0, 3-2, 3-0, 3-0.
Yes, just a totally impressive performance. 41.66 checkout percentage, 93.48, three dart average.
But we've also got some regular patrons of the embassy final. They're sitting here on the front row.
And looks like it's going to be a 6-0 scoreline. I mean, Ronnie's showing absolutely nothing, really. He just can't get started.
And looking after these rascals, as we'd like to call them, is the gentleman.
Well, I'm just looking at the record books here. John Lowe whitewashed Leighton Rees in 1979. Eric Bristow did the same to Dave Whitcomb in 1986. Dennis Priestley beat Eric Bristow, of all people perhaps, 6-0 in 91. And then in 1994, John Part beat you 6-0.
Thank you.
And it wasn't much fun, was it?
No, it's not. I mean, you know, when you lie at one set down, then two sets, then three, then four. I mean, Ronnie just, I wish he played like that against me. I'd have been there. I'd never seen him play like that. Terrible. It's all, he went for a big 28-1. It's all over the shop.
Mm. But no, then, is that just nerves there?
Well, he started off wrong. I mean, the first game, they had 26 darts Ted took for the first leg, and Ronnie had 27, and that is Mickey Mouse darts for this tournament. And, you know, it must have put him off. I mean, he started off well, he just couldn't finish, and I think that might have played on him, embarrassment. But Ted's just gone up, he's hit 8-ton 80s, 47-ton 80s now, he's got the record.
Yeah. Well, I'm delighted to say that we've got somebody here with us in the series tonight. There are a few people in the world who know more about darts than Roger Black.
So, I came for the atmosphere, not the darts, and I haven't got it.
No. What are your impressions of all this?
Well, I came here, I live down the road, and I came because I thought the atmosphere at the World Darts Final is just unlike anything else. It's so tight, it's so great, and I thought, I want to be part of that. So I came along this evening, and the atmosphere out there is very flat, isn't it? I mean, it's just disbelief. People are shocked. They just can't believe what they're seeing.
Ronnie Baxter has missed 22 out of 24 outshots. So I can't work out the percentage there, but that is less than 10%, isn't it?
It's really bad percentage.
It's bad percentage.
I mean, yeah, I'm disappointed. I made myself look an idiot, really, because I thought you'd do the bits.
Yeah.
But I've never seen him.
Well, he was 2-1
like
on with the bookies. I mean, you know, it wasn't just you, Bobby. Oh, everybody felt Ronnie was going to win this.
Well, he got out of jail twice this week. Can he get out again? But it's going to be it's hard now.
It's a bit like, I imagine, it's like sort of chasing Michael Johnson, this, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. But it's what sport is all about, this. Because I arrived here tonight, and everyone's saying, only one person's going to win. And at this level, at the final, it's what's in here. And you can see there's one man out there who is determined to win, and there's another man out there who, I don't know if he's given up, but he doesn't seem to be that interested, does he? And he's just, it's man against boy. It's what it looks like from the outsider, and it's a shame to watch, but that's the way it is.
Well, I think he's getting embarrassed, to be honest with you. Yes. If I was in his position, you'd get embarrassed,
isn't it?
And you think, come on, give us a chance. I mean, he's going for double top, and he's half inch below. You know, he's not hitting the doubles like he's a very dangerous man, and he shots out, Baxter. Yeah. Today, it's not meant to be.
Okay, well, we'll talk more in just a second. Talk about the slings and arrows of sport. This is our look back at what's been happening, the good, the bad, and the ugly of the past 10 days.
Let's play darts! It's your thing, do what you wanna do. I can't tell you who to talk to. It's your thing, do what you wanna do. I can't tell you who to talk to. If you want me to love you,
right.
And obviously our VT team put that together before this match started, but that last image, perhaps the most telling of the whole championship, a 180 from Ted Hankey. If you've just switched on, he's leading 5-0 at the halfway stage against Ronnie Baxter. No way back, is there?
Well, there is. I mean, if he plays like Ted did in the first half, you know, but it's odds of that are very remote. I'd like to see it because it would be probably the greatest sort of final ever if he come back, but it'd be difficult for him. Very, very difficult.
Okay, well, we'll talk more with you at the end, of course. Roger, thanks very much indeed. Brilliant. Go and enjoy whatever's left.
I'm either going to witness one of the greatest moments in sport, or it'll be over in 10 minutes.
So. Okay, well, this could well be the shortest final in history, but maybe, just maybe, there's a great fight back on the cards. Let's go back and rejoin our commentators.
Please welcome back Ted Hankey, Ronnie Baxter.
Well, we've seen a dazzling display from the count, Ted Hankey, as he just enters the stage area with Ronnie Baxter.
Yes, and the practice starts. And as we're looking at records, John, it's fair to note that if Ronnie Baxter should lift the title, has also won the Embassy Gold Cup Championship, which has never ever been done by any other player in the world.
Six set first leg. Ronnie to throw first. Game on.
The one thing about this is he is 5-0 down, but if he could somehow find his form, it is actually possible to come back.
Well, anything's possible.
60.
Because momentum plays such a large part of the game. And when you're hot, you're hot. And that's the same momentum that we saw in the first five sets, all with Ted.
140.
Well, John, let's hope it's a game of 2 hours on behalf of Ronnie.
Well, certainly in last year's final, Ronnie was a force to be reckoned with, and was very close to, in fact, winning the title.
And two darts at the double to win it.
140.
In fact, you know, he has the attitude now, at this point in the match, well, he's got nothing to lose now. He's already been through the bad times. He's just got to go up and play darts.
Ronnie require 121. And,
needs a 1-2-1. Go for the 20s. Treble 17. If he wants to try it, yes, maybe he'll go for the bull. Well, he's played a safe shot. Leaves double top. Ted at 303. I thought he might just try and go for that for the momentum factor, but seems to have all the best of it right now. Anyhow, double top.
Game sharp.
A different man.
Well, he wasn't even pushed.
Ted to throw first. Game on.
There's George Noble, referee, for this second half.
100.
Well, the break certainly done Ronnie a little bit of good. Taking that first leg.
60.
And in fact, with the 5-0 lead, it has to be running through Ted Hanke's mind now. Just get it over with, do it, don't let it slip away. And sometimes when you have the protective thoughts rather than aggressive sporting instincts, that's when you can slip into some trouble.
99. Ted, you require 164.
Big out shot, the highest of the championship, Steve Duke.
He would have needed to treble 18 to leave bull. He has 86 left, so treble 18 would leave 32.
96.
It's £2,000 for the highest out shot, and Steve Duke, he may be taking that back to Australia.
Well, in fact, looking very good. There might not be too much left of this final. Double four.
Well,
a chance now for 2-0 in the set as Paul Williams watches on. Ronnie Baxter needs treble 19. 18 now. Double top.
37.
And he has a little more snap in his throat, but still a miss. Double two for Ted.
2nd leg.
It was hard work, but he got it.
Well, just a slight glimpse of it.
To throw first. Game on.
Well,
180.
I certainly would have to say he's a different man since the break.
60.
Well, not where the doubles are concerned, but like you say, Johnny's scoring power is coming back. And you've got to score there to get down to the double.
60.
Well, in fact, Ronnie has the advantage of throw in this set. Started the first, third, and maybe a fifth leg.
140.
Thing is, John, these Lancastrians are good fighters, you know.
And as I mentioned earlier, it's just when you get in the position to win like this, and you're so far ahead, you don't shoot aggressively anymore. You just
tentative as you're just trying to reach and conclude the match.
Aichi won.
But no finish for Ted.
100.
And it was his favorite yesterday. Double top. He's going to take his time now. Rushed a lot of shots earlier in the match.
Game shot in third leg. Ronnie Baxter.
Whatever he did, it worked.
Throw first. Game on.
But when you think, John, we're in the sixth set and Ronnie has only won
125.
Well, he's won as many legs since the break as he did before the break, which is the really scary thing for him.
137.
And Ronnie is really in a groove.
100.
Some down jump to a finish.
Yes, and Ronnie looking to get to a better one. Just in case. Yes.
140. Ted, you require 136.
It's two treble 20s. Oh, he likes the 16s. But it won't happen now. 129 left. 114 left.
82. Ronnie, you require 124.
A good chance for this. We'll start with the 20s. Treble 18. Can't do it now.
92. Ted, you require 54.
Well, he'll go for the 14 for double top. Double 10.
34. Yes,
these are the nervous darts when you're just trying to get it done.
32.
But 32 for the set. Double 16.
No score.
Oh, I thought it was in.
And can you believe it? It looked in from every angle, even Ronnie's. 20. Double 10. Double 5.
Game shot in a fourth leg. Ted Hanke. Fifth leg, Ronnie to throw first. Game on.
This is the big one, John.
Yes, could be the last leg of the final of the championship.
43.
And certainly opening the door for the count, Ted Hanke. He just senses he's so close.
45.
And just trying to put it in instead of just being aggressive about it.
Yes, he looks relaxed.
84.
Perhaps too much desperation in Ronnie Baxter at this point to take advantage of the little bit of tension that's creeped into Ted.
Well, against Bobby George.
58.
And also against Costampe, who was really hitting the cover shots as well.
41.
The reason why it's hard for Ted is it's such an emotional thing to win that championship. When you feel you're just about to do it, and it's very hard to keep yourself under control and composed.
190.
Well, he's looking composed there. Certainly an advantage.
85.
So, Ted has at least six darts. May go for the bull. If he hits 25, it would leave 170. He's thinking about it. Yes, 170 left.
48.
What could happen now?
What a way to take the title as Donna's there.
And nab an extra 2,000 pounds. And the
60.
Pressure's off because Ronnie without
Ted
a finish.
170.
Needs two treble 20s. Ted Hanke. There's one. There's two. The bullseye for the title. Yes! What a shot to win a world championship. The Embassy World Championship. Sit still on a 170 out shot. Unbelievable. I just don't know what's hit him. It's incredible, Tony.
Oh, dear.
It's all right winning a title for the first time, John, but 170, look at the Anki family there. There was no Anki Panky was there. 6-0 went all over. It could have been Ronnie Baxter's favourite, but there it is, everybody here. John, it was tremendous.
You couldn't ask for anything more out of a finish to a championship.
Well, we've seen everything, Rachel. We've seen her jumping up and down, but it's Ted Anki, the number fifth seed. Doesn't know where to go.
Will you now please welcome the presentation party? Please welcome Mr. Graham Blashill, the Managing Director, UK, Imperial Tobacco Limited, accompanied by Peter Dyke from World Promotions. To receive a cheque for £22,000 this year's runner-up, Ronnie Baxter! The runner-up, Ronnie Baxter! Ladies and gentlemen, what can one say? A new millennium, a new Embassy World Champion. To receive a cheque for £44,000, a magnum of Lancet Champagne, and the Embassy World Darts Championship Trophy. Embassy 2000 World Champion, Ted Hankey! The first Embassy champion of the 21st century, Ted Hankey! Ted, would you like to say something?
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, in actual fact, his manager did say before I came back on stage, Ted won't be able to say anything. When you're walking away from this great tournament, the greatest in the world, £44,000 richer, and just a couple of years ago, you were playing in our great county system, and was what you can say was a county player. Now you're top of the tree, you're the Embassy World Champion, Ted Hankey! gentlemen, first of all, to leave the stage, come on, put your hands together, Ronnie Baxter! He'll be back out later on, but ladies and gentlemen, he's going to leave the stage and be back a little bit later for photographs. Now, the happiest man in the world of darts, probably in the world, our new embassy, world champion, Ted Hanke!
Well, you can see, oh, here he comes. Here he comes, the world champion, Ted Hanke, with cup, with champagne.
There you go, stick it on there, I'll let you have a look at it.
There's some famous names been on there before you, Ted, eh?
Yeah, quite a few, haven't they?
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
You did say, it's probably obstructing the view here, but you did say, when we were chatting beforehand, that you felt that you hadn't played that well yesterday. And there was more to come. Well, you certainly proved that point, didn't you?
Well, this is it. It's the same again, because all I was up there doing was playing darts, the best that I could, you know, watch up there. I'd love to sit down and watch it, because I haven't got a clue what I did up there. I think Ronnie missed a few shots earlier on, I'm not too sure.
But I was doing...
but I was doing what I wasn't doing, I was hitting my doubles today.
But just tell us, that very first leg, when you, I think you had 26 dart finish.
Oh, that was
27. I mean, if ever there was a case of nerves.
I asked for the average.
Yeah, he did. He asked for the average, yeah.
What average was that?
Yeah. That was funny. That was a funny leg, that. I think I had the darts in that leg to start with. And I was really nervous with it being my first final. I got there and I thought, oh, God. And I was surprised that Ronnie was missing. But he kept going and kept going. I managed to get it. And I managed to settle down. And Ron didn't seem to settle down as well as I thought he would do.
No, I set off like a rocket and crashed.
Yeah. did you,
what was that?
Did you set off?
Well, I did. Straight away, I was 177, 140, something like that. Got down first and started missing. So, and after that, it was just like a steamroller.
Well, I apologise in advance.
Absolutely brilliant.
You won't enjoy this, but you will. This is the culmination of the whole thing. Here we go.
Game on.
This is the big one, John.
Yes, could be the last leg of the final of the championship.
43.
And certainly opening the door for the count, Ted Hanke. He just senses he's so close.
45.
And just trying to put it in instead of just being aggressive about it.
Yes, he looks relaxed.
84.
Perhaps too much desperation in Ronnie Baxter at this point to take advantage of the little bit of tension that's creeped into Ted.
All against Bobby George.
58.
And also against Costampe, who was really hitting the cover shots as well.
41.
The reason why it's hard for Ted is it's such an emotional thing to win that championship. When you feel you're just about to do it, and it's very hard to keep yourself under control and composed.
190.
Well, he's looking composed there. Certainly an advantage.
85.
So, Ted has at least six darts. May go for the bull. If he hits 25, it would leave 170. He's thinking about it. Yes, 170 left.
48.
What could happen now?
What a way to take the title as Donna's there.
And nab an extra 2,000 pounds. And the
60.
Pressure's off because Ronnie without a finish.
170.
Needs two treble 20s. Ted Hanke. There's one. There's two. The bullseye for the title. Yes! What a shot to win a world championship. The Embassy World Championship. 6-0 on a 170 out shot. Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. I didn't remember that. Like, I remember the 170, but I just watching it there, I didn't remember the 180 in the leg. You say, so when you're up there, you don't realise what you're doing sometimes, you're just playing darts.
At that stage, I thought, well, he's confident now. He thinks he's going to win it 6-0, so he's going for the maximum to sort of, you know, win the maximum checkout prize as well. Were you thinking along those lines?
Well, no, I mean, I set myself up for 11 sets. David Manager was saying, no matter what happens, you've got to tell yourself that you're playing 11 sets. If you're 5-0 up, 5-1 up, whatever, you're playing 11 sets. And basically, I just left myself a shot, because I think money was on a finish there.
Yeah.
I've got to leave myself a shot and then try and take it out, which it went out.
Just tell me, I'll ask both of you this, at the interval, 5-0 down, I'm sure you wouldn't have thrown in the towel, but could you see any way back?
Well, yes, because Bobby says, you don't give up until the fat lady sings, or even the fat man, for that night. So yeah. I come out all right again, but I just missed a couple of shots again, and just let Ted back in. He's doing his finishing, no problem, his 180s are going in. As simple as anything, but that 32, I thought that 32 went in.
Yeah, it's
just to give me a set, like, and I thought Christmas had come early this year.
But just again for you, 5-0 up at half time. In a sense, you didn't want that break because you were on such a roll. Yeah. Well, did any doubts creep into your mind at all at that stage?
Well, no doubt, but when I went back out, it was like starting again. You know, it was a little bit colder again, which you might have seen with the start. But I just kept telling myself that all I got to do is just keep playing, and the set that I needed when I got. I didn't expect to go out and win the next set for 6-0, because obviously you can't expect that. You go out for it, but you don't expect it. But, I mean, I think I'd like to finish 170. I forget what Ron was on there, but I chipped it and I took the set. Other than that, Ronnie would have won the set more than likely.
I think more than 170.
Bobby, go on, offer us your thoughts on that final.
Well, Ronnie didn't play like you can play, and Ted just beat him up. Not really. I mean, I can't blame him. They say it's a short final. We like to see a tighter game, but he's here to do a job, and he done the business on him. I mean, like I said, you can be two down, but you like to beat the opponent 6-0 in a final. That's the way to do it. And, you know, when they do go for you like that, and the more you struggle to catch up, the worse you get. You know, you've missed doubles, and you think, oh, he keeps getting his, why can't I get mine? I mean, all week, Ronnie's been hitting double top, first start, straight in the middle. This time he's half inch lower, then he goes higher, he's half inch higher. It just didn't go, you lad. They just wouldn't
go. No problem.
If they don't go for you, you can't do nothing about it. And the averages are near enough the same, almost 30 a dart each, so, you know.
Well, last word must go to the new world champion. Here's the question you should never ask, but how does it feel? Pretty good, eh?
Well, it feels good at the minute, but obviously it's got to take a lot of time to sink in. But whilst I'm sitting here, I'd like to thank all the lads that have been practicing with me on the build-up to this, the lads on the ship and the new men back home, to all my family back home watching and my friends. Thanks a lot. It was all for you, boys and girls.
It's going to be a good night.
Yeah, we're going to have some fun now.
Ronnie, bad luck. Ted, many, many congratulations. Yes. Ted Hankey,
the
Embassy World Professional Darts Championship champion. Thank you very much for watching over the past 10 days of this championship. Here's the next year. The World of Darts is out for the count.